Percy Flowers is known for having fast dogs. A fast dog don't always run a fox like a lot of people think he should be running. And in other words, he's using his wits to run him with. He's not using the smell of that fox he's looking for.
I've been in this county 21 years, a little over 21 years, and I've been working white liquor cases for probably 19 of those 21 years. And a lot of the moonshiners know who I am. I know who they are. Now, where they keep their steels at, that is a very secretive, they're not gonna tell me. They'll wave their hand at me when we pass on the road or I see them at the store. And they know that I know who they are. And of course, they know me.
And that's what it's about right there, the thrill of the chase.
It's just an old tradition, and here in Johnston County, there is a very large tradition of moonshiners.
It's, for years we only had fox here, and we could hunt on the outside. And, you know, like this morning, we would have tried to got after a gray fox, and, you know, the object of the game was to catch him. That game's changed a lot, you know. For us, we don't want to catch him. It's not to our advantage to catch him. And we've lost a valuable piece of game, you know, and this, you can't run him but once if you catch him. I mean, it's only one race, so he gets away more times than he gets caught.
They'll say, "Fish, I'm not as big as Percy was, you know, I'm just in it small time." And but every moonshiner that I've ever met that we've actually talked some, if Percy's name came up, Percy was the king of moonshining in Johnston County. And I think unless somebody really steps up, Percy will always hold that title in Johnston County.
Percy Flowers was probably one of the smartest human beings I ever met. What he did to make a living farming and the other things he did to make a living, hunting was just a part of that. It was all blended together in his daily activities. He was out to win. He was going to be successful in whatever he did. Whatever he put his hands or his mind to, he was going to win at it. If it was checkers, if it was cards, if it was dogs, if it was chickens, if it was business, he was there to win. You didn't want to match wits with Percy Flowers.
Flowers was a good man, I tell you. I don't care what nobody says, he was a good man. He helped all the poor people. He sure did.
So as you can see, my grandmother, she's 96 years old, and she still, if you ask her something about Percy Flowers, he was a good man. And if you ask her something bad, she'll say, "I don't know anything about it." And that's, you know, that's just the way she's lived and the way she'll live till she dies. She'll never say anything bad about them because they were good to her and she was good to them.
Grandma, huh? I'm talking about my daddy.
Yeah, huh?
Jig used to drive the car for them when they were hauling liquor to Wilson.
Well, I didn't know that, Richard. But I imagine any day he did anything for him. He did it for the church. Everywhere he go, he do something for somebody. I didn't know it all. I didn't hear it all, but the most of it.
I mean, people had to do it to survive. I mean, and you know, most of the whiskey was shipped out of the county to other states, and you know, to Raleigh and Winston-Salem, Charlotte, places like that. I mean, there was a lot drank in North Carolina. I mean, you know, in Johnson County, but the purpose of it was to, you know, make income for people's families. And you know, took somebody like Mr. Percy Flowers. He was the bootlegger of all bootleggers. And he kept the whole community. I mean, a whole area there. Well, I think he owned 10,000 acres, and he kept the whole community surviving, you know. And it was just, he was loyal to the people, and people were loyal to him. Grandmother's Polly Boykin. She was born November the 5th, 1914. She'll be 96 this coming Friday.
I'm going to tell you one thing. Polly Boykin don't drink liquor. I've never drank any in my life.
My grandfather was Benji Boykin, who became Mr. Percy's, he was known as Sugar Daddy through making liquor for Mr. Percy. My father was called Jig Boykin, and he hauled liquor for Mr. Percy.
No, I don't find fault with nobody if they want to drink. That's their business.
Well, my grandfather was arrested, as you know, she told you.
And he had a whole load of liquor on the truck, and they all got caught.
And he went to prison, and when Mr. Percy got home, then he started, you know, giving my grandmother and the family money to survive on. Because, I mean, all my grandfather was, his name was Sugar Daddy, and that's what he did. He made liquor. And so that's how the family survived, you know, and other than working, you know, the crops and stuff. We don't consider it bad. I mean, it was a way of making a living. It's no different than anywhere else where people, I mean, if they raise hogs for a living or chicken farmers or whatever, that's what they have to do to survive, and that's what was done. They lived, you know, that was a way of life, and that was a way to feed your family, so that's what they did.
Would stop in the store and go in there and get a drink or something, and he would be in the store, and it would be like they would be like God, Jesus Christ, and then over there sat Percy. I mean, that's how he was considered in this part of the country when we were children. He was just that type of individual. I heard a lot of stories about him and whiskey and I can't substantiate that he ever made any whiskey. I can't substantiate that he ever sold any whiskey, because I never saw him do either. And obviously, I'm not in a minority, because the government charged him, I think the record says, about 17 times, and they never could convict him of selling or making whiskey, which to me says a lot about him and his cunning.
It's a hard craft. A lot of the moonshiners that I know today, they'll get out there and they'll work from dark to dark, making their moonshine. Whereas a lot of the kids nowadays, they're too lazy. They're going to grow their marijuana and sell their cocaine and their pills. And a lot of the old guys that are out here doing it, they might be doing it a little slow, but they're doing it every day. They don't run, they don't fight. Most of the time, the moonshiners welcome you at the door, and they'll pretty much tell you, Fish, I knew you were coming sooner or later. They might lie to you every now and then, but you know, you can't blame a man for lying to the cops, I guess, every now and then.
Percy's dogs were winning so many field trials that it was disheartening to other hunters. You know, well, no, they were mad as hell because he was outrunning them. Mm-hmm. He had too much of an advantage. And they came up with a rule that they called cunning running. And that meant that the dog wasn't running the fox true. In other words, he wasn't behind him. He was getting in front of the pack and seeing the fox. And it penalized Percy's dogs a lot because that's what they would do. You know, they were fast. They ran for the front. It was very odd that after he died, very soon afterwards, the cunning running rule was abolished, and they went back to the way things were. But fox hunting will never be what it was before he came through, as well as a lot of other things. He did a lot to enhance a lot of things in our part of the world.
It'll never stop. As long as somebody has a recipe, there will always be somebody willing to go out there and do the work to cook it. Just, if nothing else, not for the liquor so much as for the prestige of it. And I'd be willing to put my life on that one.
I asked him one day, I said, Percy, they tell me that you made and sold a bunch of whiskey. And he said, made it or had it made? Sold it or had it sold? And that was his comment.
Good morning, Judge, what may be my fine? Good morning, Judge, what may be my fine? Good morning, Judge, what may be my fine? $50, 11, 29. They arrest me for murder and I ain't never harmed a man.
Well, they immediately, Percy was going to shoot the snake off of Joel's pants with that little, he always kept a little snub-nosed 38 in his pocket. And he was going to shoot the snake off Joel's breeches leg.
Anyway, he said they should put a fence around Johnson County and just lock them all up. Federal judge in Wilmington, North Carolina. That's how bad it was. He said, because it's just a band of crooks and they do crooked things and we should just fence Johnson County up and just let them all have fun and forget about them.
Some got 6 months. Some got a solid year.